Good evening, dear viewers. Tonight on Deep Talks, Virtual Reality on Love, Life and Experiences, the 71st episode, we have a fantastic soul with us, Shipra Uppal. Along with her is my co-host joining me, Srishti. And I am so lucky and honored that the people full of love, life and experiences have always connected to me and have extended their hands to be on Deep Talks Virtual Reality of Love, Life and Experiences. What more can I say? This lady is, you know, wearing a lot many hats, and we have to hear from her during this interview. And I'm sure the ones who will be watching us tonight will be enjoying, and the ones who will be watching us later would love to comment and share with their near ones and dear ones. So I would let co-host introduce Shipra Uppal, because it is going to be an amazing experience hosting her tonight with me, the founder of Deep Talks. I hope that you all cherish each moment. Whenever we converse, you are most probably going to smile, because these talks are going to touch your heart and mind more than mine. Thank you so much, my dear friends. I would like Srishti to introduce Shipra Uppal.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Gurindu. Thank you, Srishti.
Good evening and welcome, everyone. It is my honor to introduce to you our guest for tonight, Mrs. Shipra Uppal. Shipra Uppal is a multifaceted personality who adorns many roles as an author, editor, corporate voiceover artist, soft skill and yoga trainer, visiting lecturer, NLP practitioner, motivational counselor, and many more. Passionate about her research work, she regards herself as a master of her craft who once was just a kid with a dream to become something. She has conducted state-level researches and related analysis on environment, tourism, autism, and many more concerns. She has excelled in research and analysis, corporate event management, and public relations. Shipra Uppal is deservedly the crown winner of the Heart and Soul Most Stylish Mrs. India Beauty Pageant and the subtitle winner of Goodness Ambassador 2019 for Mrs. India Beauty Pageant. Her skills are widely recognized, and of all her notable awards and accolades, the National Women's Excellence Award 2015 by the Government of India remains her most prized possession. She received the National Women's Excellence Award from Ministry of Donor, Government of India, for conducting a number of extensive regional, national, and international level studies on various subjects for different ministries under Government of India. At this juncture, I would also like to introduce Dr. Gurleen Kokhar, a noble soul and a renowned psychologist. She has conducted so far 70 interviews with celebrated dignitaries prominent in their respective fields from all across the globe for the recognition of their innovative ideas. Dr. Kokhar is also a well-known counselor. Anyone who knows her, including me, remain eager to seek her guidance and blessings. Today, she has chosen Mrs. Shipra Uppal to share her wonderful experiences and achievements in the 71st episode of Deep Talks. I invite all of you to enjoy this terrific and inspiring conversation with her. I am sure that you will all relish this beautiful talk and participate in it by commenting, liking, and sharing it with your loved ones. With this, I leave the virtual stage of communication open to the public and ma'am for leading the way up. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Srishti, and a Thank warm welcome to Shipra Uppal. This is amazing to have you here on Deep Talks. It is indeed
Thank
said
so much.
That we are
Thank
all
so
connected by heart and mind, and this is more than a spiritual connect for me. So how do you feel now being on this show, and how do you perceive this show as, or what first came to your mind when I was inviting you for the show? What was that thought that told you that you have to come on the show and share something valuable?
First of all, please accept my heartfelt gratitude for considering me worthy of this show, for inviting me to this show, and for such a beautiful, deep, warm welcome. And I'm being very humble and very mindful for my presence here in this show. And I'm sure that I'm going to reap the maximum blessings, the maximum pleasure, the maximum benefits of this wonderful conversation that's going to take place in the next 40 minutes. And it's I, being a researcher, when I came to know of this show, I started a little bit of digging. I started seeing few of your past episodes, and they were wonderful. I was initially a little nervous, but I'm so excited. I am so thrilled. And please accept my congratulations for
Shipra,
71st
so
episode. It takes, I can understand, it takes a lot of efforts and hard work. And it's a pleasure to be able to sit with you and chat with you here on this live forum. Thank you so much.
Wonderful, wonderful. I hope this conversation becomes an interesting experience for the viewers who are going to take away some tips from you, because your life journey has indeed been fantastic. According to me, I was just going through Aspiring, the book, a coffee table book, where you have talked about your life experiences. And what more can I say? That you are adorning the roles as an author, editor, research, voiceover artist, soft skill trainer, and a visiting lecturer in many faculties, institutes. I believe that you are a lady who's multi-talented. So how did this journey of picking up one profession after another start? Was it already planned when you were a child and you went to college? Or was it something that came with one opportunity and another and you took it willingly? So we would love to know, and the audience would love to know, how did it happen? Was it after marriage or before marriage? How did, you know, this Shipra Uppal rise from an author to editor to researcher to voiceover artist and many more?
In my life, nothing was really planned. All happened as it was maybe destined, or it was, I got it as a blessing by the God. But yes, every blessing came in your life after a lot of preparation, after a lot of testing hours. Since childhood, I always used to get candid with the idea of to do something, because by the time I grew up, even from the age of, by the time, whatever the age I remember my childhood, from the age of 3 to 4 years, 5 years, I have always seen my parents discussing their offices after I used to join them in the evening. So the idea of, making your career, becoming something, getting promoted in life, and reaping the benefit of the hard work is so deeply, it's so deeply there in the hardcore of my subconscious mind that I have never thought of doing anything else. For me, life had a crux of doing something. Of course, yes. I have experienced that there's nothing can replace you with reaching what you had desired for.
True.
To fulfilling your anticipations, to fulfill your aspirations. But participation is more significant. It is more important to participate. It is more important. That's what I have learned from few of my very wonderful friends, and of course, from my parents. So wonderful. I have seen their struggling years. I have seen them working so hard. And one thing I've learned, that nothing comes overnight. You have to work extremely, extremely hard. Now, from the journey of getting into so many careers and into with so many titles, is that nothing was planned. Nothing was planned. When I was a child and during my teen years, like, since I have always seen my mother working. So I too had a desire to follow her footsteps and keep on doing something one after another. But had an intrinsic desire. I also had a deal with myself that I would always be available to my children. My children would never miss me. So once I was blessed with a child, with my first child, and there on the second child, I immediately, I just left everything. For first 2-3 years, I decided nothing doing. And slowly when he was in pre-nursery, so I began with freelancing, like Life presented me with an opportunity of freelancing, and by that time, I would like to share a. I was also in Chandigarh. I spent 5 years in
Wonderful.
Mohali. Yes.
Yes.
So my
That's
freelancing
wonderful.
began from there. My freelancing
That's
began from there.
that's an amazing experience, being a mother and still continuing with your job, but initially thinking about your own child, because you know it's a beautiful feeling to be a mother.
It's a
And I
beautiful
assume the
feeling.
people who have witnessed this feeling, and they are blessed. Indeed, it is a journey. Life is a
It is a
journey.
journey.
It is a journey. So I believe
It is a
when
journey.
you were switching on and taking opportunities from being a mother to a freelancer, you also believe somewhere in motivation. And people define motivation in different ways. I would love to know from you that self-motivation is a term that people hardly know. You know, sometimes there, you know, people are in a very, very different mood to define self-motivation. Do you believe in success? Self-motivation does count for 70% of what you are doing and what is the product of what you do. Because I do believe in self-motivation, except those external factors which keep revolving around you. Could be the environment, could be anything. So do you believe that your life, wherever you are today, is because of somewhere you yourself self-motivating yourself every time that you faced a failure?
Colleen, there have always been ups and downs in the
Yes.
life. Because when I started with freelancing, then of course, one after another, I started getting the opportunity. I have even worked as a teacher just for the
Yes.
sake of working for on a short shifts, on a short time basis, to be able to be available to my child as and when there was a need. Then, of course, I very thoroughly believe that accomplishments never comes alone. They are
True.
always being given by the support of your people. It was the back end confidence that
Yes.
pulled me through to keep on doing something when I know that I'm not going to be stopped by anyone. Rather,
True.
people, I had a few supports at home. I had my And during all these years, and I have seen my life partner, I have seen my husband, even silently, he was absorbing my pressures. He
That is
silently absorbed my
fantastic.
pressures.
Yes, it is
So, and
fantastic to
being a
have a
woman,
prominent husband by your side, because it counts a lot when you are undergoing something and you know the other partner also feels it, and that is important. Feelings are really important, but more important is understanding, mutual understanding. And you are lucky to have that mutual understanding, that you and your husband share a great mutual understanding. Not many couples do share that, and these days even more so. People are going for divorces because there's hardly the you know, there's loss of patience, perseverance and tolerance. Not much I can say on that topic, but definitely I believe that if you are succeeding, your husband also equally joins hand and understands the situations and makes you move ahead, because ultimately it's a joint effort, and including your
it is a
kids
joint
now.
effort.
Yeah,
It is a
it is
joint
a
effort.
joint. Yes, so it is indeed wonderful to have Augustine saying, wonderful to see you, inspiring. That is wonderful. Thanks a lot for joining in this conversation tonight, because with people like you commenting, sharing, it becomes even more interesting. We come to know. When you comment, we come to know who's watching and what could be your questions. I would be, you know, loving enough to ask Shipra Uppal some questions by the audience itself. And it is always amazing when people participate
Okay.
lightly, as Shipra
That would be
said,
my
that
pleasure if I'm able to
participation
answer
is
something.
smart. Yes. So, yes, we would love to know from Shipra furthermore about her life journey, because I have heard that she has stated patience and perseverance goes a long way. How can you relate that with an experience where you had a failure and you understood that patience and perseverance took all that to achieve the success? Like, I can say that you have many awards to yourself. You have also been the crown winner of Heart and Soul Most Stylish Mrs. India Beauty Pageant and subtitle winner of Goodness Ambassador 2019 for Mrs. India Beauty Pageant. It is wonderful and fantastic feeling to participate because I know to walk a ramp, you require that courage, and not only the courage, but presence of mind when you're answering the questions in itself. So even on this interview, when people come, they have a loss of, loss of a feeling to answer some questions because they are based on the real life experiences of humans, their own experiences. Sometimes they shy away, sometimes they feel, oh, we cannot answer this question. But I would love to know from you, Shipra, how did this happen, the crown in itself, and what was your feeling, and how did you choose to walk the ramp with Ilan?
I have to be very honest here. The crowning thing has not, I mean, everything, life has offered me things on platter.
Yes.
Because during my first year of graduation, I got an offer to participate in Miss Delhi University contest. And because I was in, I'm based in Delhi. And I turned down that offer considering, and I was being even given to believe that I was too young to participate in beauty pageants, and studies were more important. So I had to focus on my studies. So I let go of that idea. And during, and even after, during the last year of my graduation, I got an offer to participate in Miss East Delhi contest. And I had the same anticipations in mind, and I turned that down too, and focused on my studies and towards my professional courses. So years rolled on, life went on as it was going, and new and good things were happening slowly and steadily with the pace of life as they are doing, and they were going ahead. Suddenly, life offered me this Mrs. India beauty pageant. And just before that, Heart and Soul had honored me with their honorary chairperson position, and they hosted an event, and it was happened to be their first auditions too. So I went into that in those auditions, and there I refused to participate in
Gosh.
Those contests, and it was the jury, the learned people who were sitting there as a part of the jury, they motivated me. And they encouraged me that, no, you should not say no. It says Mrs. India. So, of course, everybody who's coming here are married. Everybody who's coming there are a mother
Definitely.
Of children. So this is not a setback. Because
yes.
I had started considering that now after becoming a mother, the age is not on my side. So
yes.
I was being given a reverse idea that age is not a taboo. Rather,
yes.
age is an acumen. Age is an experience
True.
That
True.
Will convert a fruit into a vinegar,
yes.
which is a health supplement.
Yes.
So,
yes.
take it in your stride, use your experience. And as far as walking the ramp is concerned and participating and answering the questions, it was a journey of entire 10 months long journey. And I can never forget whatever I have lived and learned all during those days, and the experiences that I gathered, and there were certain, in 10 months there were so many rounds. So there was a talent round in which we were required to dance, and I could not match any of those wonderful participants because I have always feel very shy, and I always feel like running away from those gorgeous ladies. So but that gave me a strength. And as far as the walking the ramp is concerned, I hope Archana, I don't know whether she's watching, but I hope and I believe that definitely she is present watching the show. And she was the one who groomed us for this pageant. She was the one she introduced with every small tidbits, nick and corners, do's and don'ts that need to be followed. I had no information, no knowledge, no experience of what is even the head ramp, what is the foot
yes.
ramp, how to walk it, how to stand. And she guided us thoroughly. And then it was all go ahead. So
it's a fantastic
walking the ramp on its own.
Yes. It is wonderful to have Archana, you know, guiding because she is a great soul. She appeared on my show. The previous episode, Archana
Definitely.
Was there. And it's wonderful, and through her we connected. It is amazing to connect to special souls, and I call them special because They take the initial steps to befriend and make life much easier. And everybody
Yes.
has a talent. And I'm sure that you did not know that you could walk the ramp so well. But Archana tried to tell you and guide you, and it has turned out to be an amazing, amazing gift for you in a way you will cherish throughout the life that you are living. And I'm sure the most prized possession that I have read about is your winning the National Women's Excellence Award in year 2015 by the Government of India, which is your fame. And I'm so sure this is not an easy one. It has not come just like that. It has to do with a lot of hard work. And I'm so glad that a lady has excelled in this, and the Government of India has awarded you with this award. It means a lot. And it's my honor to even host you tonight, because it really means something to the people who are watching, because anybody can take any tip and improve their life at any moment is what I think. When you have to improve your present, you can also get influenced by a single thought. A seed of thought can actually make a difference in somebody's life. And that is how on mental health, I start this thought that this program is going to influence many people, not only ladies, but even the gents who are sitting at home and watching this show, even the kids who can actually learn a lot from this. How have you got this award, and how was the journey in preparing to receive this award? Were you actually manifesting that you're going to receive a National Women's Excellence Award, or was it that you never actually thought that I am working for a reward? Because I believe when you are working for a reward, you don't work that much. When you're working with passion, that is a time when rewards come to you itself. So what is your take on it?
First of all, here I would say, when you said that we all sometimes have a zero idea of what is going to life is going to offer us ahead. I would say that zero is something, is a very important figure. It's a very important figure. When it gets added after a value or after a number, the value gets added. So it is the same kind of explanation. It's the same kind of thought or virtue that get associated with your experiences that you reap. And
true.
As far as awards are concerned, awards doesn't come like it is accumulated result of
true.
Years of work. And here in my profile, the basic gist is my research and analysis only. And here again, I would say that my research and analysis is also could happen because of someone's support in my life, my previous seniors whom I was working with chambers, and they pushed me into the researches. And during my life, my first biggest international based study was that scenario of Indian pharmaceutical industry and healthcare industry in Gulf Cooperation Council. And I had no courage. Nothing knew about researches, nothing at all. So my seniors, they pushed me into it. They said, we are standing here. They guided me step by step how to go ahead. I'm very grateful for the various embassies that were associated, and they extended the support of presenting the real life, the health scenario of those states, the GCC states, and what is the kind of the experiences being shared or being taken by the Indian exporters and importers who were dealing with Gulf Cooperation Council and the Food and Drug Administration over there. And it came out to be all success. It got distributed to all Indian ambassadors in GCC states and GCC ambassadors in India. And it got published in all the leading newspapers. And then my second international study was scenario of Indian ICT industry in the Scandinavian region. Because those days, I'm talking about 2004, those days, the ICT industry had a very weak foothold, especially in this part of the European countries. So thereafter, after being blessed with children after getting married, I started conducting the regional and state level studies. I joined consumer forums. I joined
Wonderful.
Jago Grahak Jago and all. And with the great blessings of God, I was allowed to work from home. I was required to
Wow.
go to their offices only as and when they were required. So basically, it
Very
is all the
lucky, very
researches and things
fortunate.
that I have to do. Yeah, so we
Yes.
conducted another study called Right to Healthy Environment that was presented to Ministry of Consumer Affairs. There were 16 NGOs who participated in that particular thing. And luckily, with the kind of blessings and the kind of support and the guidance that I was receiving from the seniors associated with me, our study got selected in the ministry. It got published. And then even the kind of analysis and the suggestions that we raised as far as regarding the raising the sustainability factor for the current availability of goods and services, because India was that time was not able to match the demand and supply graph. The
Yes.
supply was very high and the availability
Very
of goods and services were very limited. So the spurious, the adulteration of factors were taking ahead and people were falling ill. That is one of the culprit factor involved in the rising number of autism in India.
Yes.
Because
Yes, I've read
it
about
is the
it that you've been
adulterated
researched.
food what the mother is consuming, and this is how it is going, is affecting the child's health. So
True.
going by the statistics, going by the data, if I talk about, say, 40 years down the line, or 35 years down the line, or 45 years down the line, there used to be one child in
Yes.
100 who used to
Hundreds.
be down with Down syndrome or any kind of a brain anomaly. But now, if you see
It's rising.
every school
Yes.
has a special education department. Every
Very
school has, and now the if I rate the children in between 1 to 20, I think two children are going to be depicted with any,
Yes.
even the hyperactivity or these kind of small
That's true.
anomalies.
Learning disorders are also rising. The cases that
So
I have been
it
getting.
was the collaboration of all these researches and the suggestion that was being raised to the ministries, and there were certain things that he was that Consumer Forum even
Yes.
presented to Consumer Forum presented to the Parliament also, and
Oh,
it was luckily got accepted over there. So
wonderful.
when we talk about the adulteration factor especially, so
Yes.
those days the mustard oil adulteration was quite on rise high.
True.
I'm talking about it, those areas, those times.
Yes.
So it
Yes.
was the joint, it is the conclusive results of all these things that somehow I was being blessed with this opportunity.
Yes. No, no, it is indeed fantastic to see a lady conducting number of extensive regional, national, international studies on various subjects for different ministries under Government of India, because I do believe that very few ladies I've met have actually talked about rising cases of autism and subjects like you have talked about. And you've also conducted a study on scenario of road safety in India based on the SWOT analysis. So
Yes.
would you like to talk about something on the road safety, like you have conducted a study. So did you find conducting a study on the scenario of road safety in India was ready on the SWOT analysis? How do you take the situation now?
Actually, there was a demand being raised by MoRTH, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, because 2013 was the year that was marked as a black year, considering the highest number of road accidents in India.
Yes.
2013 was the year, and even that was just a year preceding or after was a year when our Honorable Minister Gopinath Munde also died
Yes.
in a road accident.
Road
So
accident.
it was after, during those years only, when MoRTH had raised a demand, a need to that a study should be conducted and proper analysis should be made. The entire SWOT analysis should be there If I say about SWOT analysis, it means the strength concluding and analyzing the strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats associated with the present scenario of road accidents or the how the law governing the roads or the traffic police really people do really do they care about the traffic rules. And while conducting that study, I had considered every small nation corner, and government was majorly concerned about this study in association with the rising number of accidents concerning the small children, school
Yes.
children, because during that year school children were the major victims. There was a small things, few points that we never noticed. That maximum number of accident, they happen near your home vicinity only. When
yes.
a child see a parent approaching and they don't have a direction sense, they don't have a traffic sense, it was just a spur of an excitement. They run after their parent and then there is a
yes.
boom. So, and then morally, I would say that there was a lot of workshops and lot of orientation that was being raised for the parents also through
yes.
the schools, through the schools program. Because here in India, during those timings, like there were high number of road rages, road fights
yes.
that used to happen on road, where people have zero tolerance of somebody
yes.
overtaking their vehicle. So here the approach was being raised that please tell your child, do
yes.
what I say, but please don't do what I do.
True, very
it's
true, very true, and very important
yeah.
point actually, because that is so important
yeah.
to train your children, educate them in
yeah.
a right manner, because that's really
yes.
important.
Because children are good
yeah.
imitators. They are wonderful imitators. They will definitely imitate what they are seeing, their parents doing. With great apologies, I don't wish to pinpoint anybody, but this is a gross statement that was being made after a lot of because we even approached the police stations concerning
yes.
the number of complaints, FIRs that has been registered as far as a road rage or road accident deaths were concerned. And maximum time it was overspeeding, it was breaking of laws, it was most of the time road rages also. And you might have heard the number of people firing the police cops
yes.
on duty when they
yes.
got short-tempered or being asked about something.
Point. Yes, you
yes.
are raising some issues that are really relevant enough, and people should learn the traffic rules. Plus it's indeed an honor if somebody is trying to learn something, because it doesn't harm anyone. In fact, the amount
yes.
of road accidents increasing every day. They are proving hazardous to everyone, and every family is losing someone or the other. So
and
please, my dear viewers, watching us,
and
yes,
as I
take
said,
a note.
Our own minister, he was the minister of transport only who got died in a road accident. So
yes.
this was a very painful incident for India, for our government, for our people. And more so, what happens that as far as the law governing the traffic rules are concerned, there were 16 authorities that was being associated with different rules. If in case
True.
You are going to ask for embark about one particular thing, then one authority would say that we have a limited role, go to that pole,
True.
Go to the second
yeah.
office. So the person
yes.
is roaming all through, roaming around and not reaching a conclusion.
Ringa roses.
So there has to be one authority who's taking in charge of all the rules, all the regulations,
yes.
all the things. And so that, because in people in Chandigarh, since I have spent 5 years over there, now I see everywhere. Even I'm a resident of Noida, I have seen people following the traffic rules. There has been so much of awareness. There have been so much of traffic rules. People follow them so diligently. They are so serious
yes.
about it. And even if in case it is, at times we travel back and come back at 1 o'clock at night and we see people getting stopping at red light, even though the roads
right.
are empty.
Much
this
needed,
is
much
what
needed. Yes.
This
much
is
needed.
How you see a change.
Exactly. So you have been a research editor. You have gained the National Women's Excellence Award in year 2015. Not only that, you're a woman of substance. You have also Then animated, it contains short series covering course curriculum starting from classes 1 to 12 on all subjects from Ministry of Human Resources Development. And that's amazing. So how did this journey of voiceover artist start? We would love to know. And there are some viewers who have joined us and commented. Dalveer Sandhu has said, hello, beautiful ladies. Wow, congrats. So many achievements. Nilesh Tayare has said, hello. Srishti Sharma has pointed out, very inspiring, beautifully said. Right, people don't have road sense. Thank you so much, viewers, for joining us and listening to a conversation, because that does make us feel that you're all connected and what we are talking, you can relate to it. So, yes, Shipra, so how did this voiceover artist journey start, and how did this happen? This animated content short series covering course curriculum for the Ministry of Human Resource Development. This is amazing to know that you have actually covered each and every area that a woman can only think of, and you can be an inspiration for those women sitting at home that even after becoming a mother, there is not a full stop. There is still life beyond that full stop. There is a comma. You can just carry on with your life with a smile and with all the challenges that you face. Many people think that, yes, like you actually believe that age could be a barrier, but you broke the barriers, like I'm breaking the barriers to communicate and express ourselves even more better so that it can help somebody. So how did this journey happen, and how did you go in for e-content short series?
Here, I would say, first of all, being a mother, that was the instinct that encouraged me to go ahead and do all these things. Because conducting a road study for rising number of road accidents against for the children,
Yes.
it is because being a parent, our life revolves around children. We are
Yes.
really concerned about their safety. We are really concerned about their safe come back to our home. And being a mother, again, I would say that it is a nothing was planned. Even this was not planned. It happened suddenly. And here also, I will give the onus to my family, the people, because they encouraged me to get into this. I had no confidence. I had no experience in recording any e-content series or any voiceovers, nothing. And I started by, it started in 2013. It started
Wonderful.
in November 2013 when we started recording. It was an education program by the Ministry of Education and Ministry of Human Resource Development for the KV
Wonderful.
schools all over India. And it was a concept of promoting e-learning among students.
Yes.
And who knew that it was something that today, standing in 2021, everything is e-learning, everything is online. And
True.
during those time in 2013, it was a new concept that was introduced. The e-content was developed by KV teachers under the guidance
Yes.
of the subject teachers, the subject
Yes.
experts. And the school
Yes.
website was an attempt to bring classrooms on these platforms by
Wonderful.
integrating experts' expertise and enable the children to log on to these videos
Yes,
sitting
true.
anywhere, be in school in the form of, because during that time also there was an inception of smart classes.
Yes,
Introduced everywhere in
very right,
the
exactly.
private schools also, in the government schools also, in the elite schools also. So there were smart classes where a projector used to be portrayed against the blackboard, just side of the
Yes.
blackboard. And these e-content series were as an added effort of explaining the
Yes.
concepts, because there are four ways of learning.
Sure.
Like few children, they get much better idea by just in going through the traditional methods of reading and seeing the blackboards. Second
True.
concept goes by listening if they have a good auditory skill. And third
Yes.
concept goes by viewing as a video. So introducing the concept of e-learning by through smart classes really help children
Yes.
to accept and acknowledge the things in a much shorter time, quickly.
Yes, much
And
duration.
it was just like introducing coming up with the 2D and 3D animated concepts with relative voiceovers, starting
Yes.
from class 1 to class 10. And
True.
being a mother, I started with narrating his stories, model
Wonderful.
based stories.
In those times,
Model
you know,
based
there were no
stories.
storytellers like, you know, yesteryears, you can say that grandma used to tell a story and the children used to sleep. But now it has become a paid profession. Storytelling is an art in itself, and
It's an
people
art.
pay, sending their kids to listen to a
I
story.
enjoy doing it so much that more those moral based stories like The Friend in Tea, The Friend in Need, and etc., these kind of stories. So I started enjoying it, and then slowly, steadily, it raised above classes, narrating those mathematic concepts or chemistry concepts to the higher classes, and then the journey went on.
Went on. It is amazing, Shipra, to just know that you have been juggling many tasks, many roles, and you relate to every Indian woman in one way or another. It's amazing
Yes.
to host you. And there is Geeta Sharma stating, being a mother brings you great amount of strength for sure. Definitely, Geeta, thanks a lot for joining in. And I'm sure the ones who are watching us, they will gain something or the other. You are actually going to be feeling motivated and inspired, because Shipra Uppal is actually a woman of substance, according to me, and one has to learn a lot.
Thank you so much.
Everyone.
And here I would like to add a small statement that a lady who becomes, like, if a mother is trying to do something, then definitely she has a back end support
Yes.
standing to take care of other things at the back
Yes.
end.
Yes.
Otherwise, it is not all that easy. As I said, my husband absorbed my pressures silently.
True.
He
True.
absorbed my pressures. I know there have been, like,
Yes.
being a lady and being a female, we even go through a lot of hormonal changes and we react differently
Lot.
to.
Yes. I'm sure that this journey of your marriage in itself has proved valuable for you, Shipra, because you are lucky and fortunate enough to receive all these awards with your husband and your family, because there are very few families who sit together, dine together, and make a goal together. And that's wonderful to hear that despite all the differences, we should actually gear up for challenges together and be united no matter whatever comes in our
And
life.
here, with the core of my heart, I raise a prayer that it is that everyone should get this, should be there with these blessings, should be
Yes.
there. It is a prayer that has been raised from the core of my heart.
True. Thanks a lot, Shipra. That is indeed amazing. And Dalveer Sandhu has said, agree, moms have supports at home. Thanks a lot, Dalveer, for stating such a wonderful statement. I'm sure mothers are really enjoying this conversation, and the ones who are single, definitely look out for the ray of hope. And I'm sure that you all have a chance to be on my show itself. See, every show has some value, but this show is about breaking the barriers and befriending people from across the globe, and also improving the mental health services by talking about such topics that are not talked about and people hesitate to talk about it openly. So I have started this initiative and it is of value, and soon we will be coming with an announcement when there will be 100th episode, and we will be rejoicing in that moment of witnessing our journey from the first to the 100th episode and marking a century, my dear viewers, because with the love that you have showered on us and the blessings that you have shard on us, I have kept moving, and I'm sure that this challenge for me is becoming even more hard, because the people who are coming on my show, they are full of zest to live life, and they're full of so many achievements that, you know, when I type, I actually think that so many people have done so much that, you know, you have to learn from everyone. It's not one soul who has achieved and they boast about the achievements. It's about the you know, the way they are humble, the way humanity is moving. It's a milk of human kindness that should be alive more than boasting about your achievements. And I really love and appreciate this about Shipra Uppal. Do you believe that failure is a better teacher than success, Shipra? That is my question to you. Because I definitely do believe in it. Every failure teaches you something, and you are bound to rise even more in life when you are actually in deep down a low phase. You can call it in mental health, or you can call it anyway. So do you believe that one failure can lead us to success sooner or later?
There is a saying goes, if you have not failed, you have not lived.
True.
Because you don't get that frustration. You don't
True.
get that anger. You don't
Yes.
get that embarrassment of doing it
Yes.
again and doing
Yes.
it with a better force to do it, correcting your own mistakes
Yes.
without any feeling of shame or resentment. So if failures are not there, failures is an opposite of success. Failures,
True.
had failures not been there, success definitely wouldn't have been creating such a great value or had been so precious for the people who achieve it. So
yes.
failures are the great teachers. And I say that failures and success, they start from the very beginning of your journey, from the very small
yes.
age. At every small age, you learn from your failures only. And after reaching a certain age, if I talk about my age bracket, if I talk about like the people who are there with my age bracket, now after reaching a particular milestone, we turn
yes.
back and we count on the things that we have been able to do, that we have been able
yes.
to achieve, and
yes.
the things we aspire for our younger generation, that what we have not been able to do, maybe it is done by them. So
yes.
our experiences, our mistakes, our learnings can be a better roadmap for them to
True.
be able to go ahead more confidently. And
Yes.
if I say that counting on your milestones and packing it delicately in your
Yes.
memory bank and presenting that legacy to
Yes.
the youngers, to the youngsters,
Wonderful. Yes.
be it in any way, by presenting more corporate talks or by
yes.
presenting more motivational counseling or maybe doing more schooling or by any way. So as far as I'm concerned, yes, of course, like everybody, as I relate to every normal Indian woman, I am also a normal Indian woman who
yes.
have learned so much from my own mistakes. So here I would say that my failures have embraced me with a close focus on
yes.
my goals. Because
Wonderful. That is important.
As I
yes.
said, because it is a failure that you will get more anger. Your failures only are going to generate that embarrassment in you. You know,
exactly.
that frustration
right.
in you, that why isn't it happening? So, and I keep on seeking something. I have always been seeking something larger than
yes.
my life, than my size, than what I am right now. I need, if I'm this, I want this. So,
yes.
and I was always ready with the kind of hardships, the repeated trials that it is needed. And of course, I am a very spiritual person. I very deeply believe that nothing happens without prayers. So it
yes.
is the prayer that really makes the things done. I was all with repeated number of trials, you are standing steady tight with your bandwagons already, that let whatever is being there, I'm going to keep on doing no matter what, how many trials I have to get. So
very
my greatest, so these are the things that we really embrace. And
yes.
of course, we are going to present our mistakes as a learning experiences for our younger people.
Very true, very true. And Archana Zoya has finally commented, wonderful conversation of two amazing women. Now, we are lucky to have you, Archana. Thanks a lot for
yes,
connecting
lucky
us.
To have you. Thank you for coming.
Great feeling when you see someone commenting, connecting people. It gives me an amazing feeling that they are lovely souls around and they give great positive vibes. And it is indeed our honor to have you seeing us. And I'm lucky to have Shipra Uppal tonight. And Srishti Sharma has rightly stated, failures make you humble and teach you the value of achievements. They are very important in life, and mistakes are one of the most important teachers. Very true. In fact, a lot many people have joined us tonight, would love to share this conversation with their near dear ones when this episode is over. And I believe that your continued support will keep this episode going, because Once you view this, you will understand the meaning of why we are holding these shows. So we would love to ask Shipra Uppal something that she has done a study on. And it's very, very important to know from her the views about child consumerism in India. Like I've read about you and you've done a lot of research. So we would love to know what are the views on child consumerism in India, according to you, and what should be done?
Child consumerism, if I say that, children, neither they earn nor they carry any purse with them.
Yes.
They don't carry any money with them. But still, they are the driving force behind every kind of market buying the products, because children, they remain very upright about, I need the best thing in the market, whatever is
True.
Available. So if we see the number of the arrays and the number of advertisements that children see on their television, that
yes.
becomes the driving force for them to raise the demand that I need this. I really need
yes.
this. So child consumerism is presented both positively and negatively. And it is
yes.
there in all the industries. It is there
True,
in all the industries, in every industry. So children are, they get candid with the idea of seeing not only things in the advertisement on live TVs, but also following their friends. And
yes.
Be it McDonald's, be it a candy
yes.
industry, be it
True.
The apparel industry, be it the automobile
yes.
industry, be it the schooling and education, being the sportswear. So child consumerism, children are the driving force and convincing their parents to go ahead and buy us those things. So
True.
child consumerism in India is a leading buying force where children constantly get exposed to the advertisements, and they become the victim of the advertising strategies also. I'm
Yes.
sorry to say that, but
yes.
and the messages and the hidden messages that are being conveyed to them. So there have been, that is why child consumerism reached those heights and it was
yes.
accepted widely.
Yes.
Because we see live example is present in every house, and we
yes,
love
true.
Those examples. We love to
Yes.
fulfill their demand.
Very true, very true. So very rightly stated by you about child consumerism, and you have presented your views. It's indeed significant to know that you've conducted your researches on very, very important topics. And this was fantastic to hold you. I do share a quote on my show. The aging is not a negative term. Rather, it gives an impetus to deal with things in a more mature manner. Somewhere we spiritually connected, and before the show rolled in, you shared something which I had already written prior. So this is amazing, my dear viewers, to notice that there is an energy that follows and connects with another soul. So I have written, aging is not a negative term. Rather, it gives an impetus to deal with things in a more mature manner. And she stated the same. So it's so wonderful to know that without even knowing and meeting a person, you can know through a coffee table book and her interview that what thoughts she is holding and what is she coming along with. She is not a simple soul, my dear viewers. She's something full of life and full of passion to do much more towards the development of the nation. And I'm so very honored today that I got a chance through Archana to host her. It means a lot, because the people who are coming on this chair, they're holding value to me. If you value every human being on this planet, you will definitely, definitely be a better human being. There's a deep tip that I share: rolling in good times is easy, but striving to speak during failures takes balls. And that is what I do believe in. I do believe in the same. I, as a bold woman, always would want to talk on topics that people don't talk on. Because this is something that is killing all of us. If we don't share, if we hesitate, we cannot learn to grow. That is a main line that I follow. That is how this name Deep Talks has arrived. And it is making a presence in every home. And I hope that you all like this conversation tonight. And one last message from Shipra Uppal tonight for the viewers who have joined us and the ones who will be watching us later would be: welcome Now, so Shipra, one last message for the audience who would be watching you. I'm sure there will be a lot many people liking you and connecting to you, and they can easily befriend you on the Facebook once you approve their friendship. And I'm sure there's a lot to learn from you in coming times. But one last message to all the ones who are watching and for the show itself.
First of all, it will be a pleasure for me. It will be a blessing if people consider me worthy of their friendship, if they would consider me worthy of getting connected. And it is a blessing if you think and consider me worth a token that I can inspire somebody. So here, the message, if you talk about the message, I would say that see, it is said that nothing really happens overnight. You cannot
Yes.
achieve your destinations overnight, but you
True.
can change your directions overnight.
Yes.
You can think that maybe this route is not it can be a shortcut, but it may not yield me to the permanent results what I'm seeking for. So you may like to change your directions.
True.
Even though it is filled with a lot of hardships. So
Yes.
I would say that be a role model to somebody. My
True.
message here is to be a role model to somebody, and there is no fun of counting achievements of my own. Whatever the little achievements, whatever little I am today. So it is all better to be a role model to someone and enjoy your challenges. Enjoy whatever the
And
challenges that came. Confront your
yes.
barriers and move ahead with, because finally, maybe our challenges are new, but the values
Yes.
upon which those challenges depends are honesty, fair play, hard work. And nothing comes without hard work. Nothing
True.
comes
Very true.
without repeated trials, without spending half of your energy and age and your travel into one particular line. So
True.
maybe these values are awful tasting medicines. Maybe they
Yes.
don't taste good, but finally you need it to get back to
Yes.
life.
Wonderful,
You
wonderful.
have to take it. You have to follow the course. So my suggestion is what I always say. Even I said it to Archana, to Zoya also, that please adopt an epic in your
Yes.
life.
Very
Because
right.
epic, and if I say I'm a researcher, so it
Yes.
means research, searching
Yes.
something that has already been discovered. So it is not
True.
something that I have presented something new. I have been searching for something that was years back, or maybe I say centuries and civilization back, has been researched by somebody. So
Yes.
Gita will help you in all kind of with emotional stability and emotional turmoils, and it will help you to come up and
Yes.
disconnect with your agonies and respond to any situation and confound with them. Confound with the past pains and come up and shines up brightly as the way it should be.
True. True. Wonderful. Wonderful. That's an amazing message by Shipra Uppal tonight. My dear viewers, it's amazing to know Shipra Uppal's journey, and I hope that you stay glued for the next show, and we will let you know when is the next episode. But thanks for sharing your thoughts, comments, loving and liking this conversation, and I hope that you do comment and share this video with those who are sitting at home or those who would love to hear us and our conversations, because there's everything to learn from someone who has a lot to offer, and what more
Yes.
to offer than unconditional love, which we are offering on this show. Thanks a lot, Shipra Uppal, for joining me tonight. It was wonderful hosting you. Thanks a lot. And my dear viewers, have a great time, peaceful sleep, stay safe, and stay connected.
Thank you so much, Colleen, for